starts off with some narration. You know damn well it starts off with some narration. How else would it start? How else do you start your crime action hood movie? It's a crime action hood movie, by the way.
My name is, well, forget about my real name. Everybody out there call me Beans. I know we don't look like much right now, but you'll see.
Beanie Sigel's the main character. He like a bum or whatever. He's like a low-level hustler. He don't be getting no money. He look crazy and dirty. His facial hair look crazy and terrible. Also his shape up too. I could go all day really. He not getting no money though. That's why he look all crazy. Let's give him a break, it's fine. He at the strip club with his homeboy. In the middle of the day, well, there's your problem right there, Beanie Sigel. You shouldn't be broke at the strip club. Everything is so overpriced. It's not worth it at all. Also, strippers don't like that.
You're sitting up in this fucking bar in the middle of the day doing what? Nothing. I need that big ass fucking crib, man. My moms and my girls decked out living lovely. Yo, pretty soon, man, you're gonna be able to do what the fuck you want.
He randomly gets inspired out of nowhere to start being a better drug dealer. He tells his homeboy all about his vague plan to get to the top of the dope game. This nigga here name is Baby Boy. They best friends or something. He's another Philly rapper also, by the way, in real life. Just like Beanie Sigel. They both rappers. That's why they're acting so bad.
Fuck that shit you was talking earlier today. What up?
Holla at me now.
What's up, bitch?
Oh my god.
Speaking of bad acting and obscure rap niggas, Memphis Bleek shows up in the movie. He comes in and randomly murders some random guy with no setup at all. It's pretty gangster.
Yo, I'm telling you, man, we need a motherfucking killer like that on our squad for real.
There go that nigga right there.
Yo, Blizz!
Here you go.
Yo, Blizz, man.
Yo, fuck it's me, nigga. Niggas,
baby boy, and Beanie Sigel's impressed by the way Memphis Bleek shoot random people for no reason. He wants him to join their team or something. Also, this nigga that got killed at the strip club, was this nigga by himself at the strip club? That's so convenient, right? You would think he'd have some homeboys with him or something.
You need your homeboys.
But yeah, they got a little team together now and they roll up on some old nigga. He liked the big drug dealer in the area. Beanie Sigel tells him that he's taking over the whole hood. You gotta get down or lay down. That's his catchphrase or something. He say it a lot. I like it.
Come on, man. Get this little crazy motherfucker. Listen, bitch, you don't have to do this. There's enough in this for both of us, man.
That's where you fucking wrong at, you fat motherfucker.
Fat. Oh, you fudge. Didn't I tell you fudge? Didn't I? Fat fuck. Fat motherfucker.
Beanie Sigel takes over all the old nigga territory and he rich now. He gets extra fresh or whatever, I guess. He still look pretty crazy though. I don't know if this is supposed to be a glow up. This nigga look exactly the same. Cut that shit off your chin, bro.
Damn, jeans. Your ass fat. It's like,
hi, baby.
Ain't nothing. Mwah. I gotta go handle some business with baby boy later.
You sure? I'm not trying to hear that shit. The moral beans. Who tried to talk to you? What you wear? What time you came? Nobody ain't calling me. I'm not trying to.
Beanie Sigel's hanging out with his sexy ass, ratchet ass baby mom. He must be selling a lot of these drugs, bro. Good for him. Then they kill some more drug dealers after that. They taking over more territory. They selling a lot of drugs now, I guess. They don't actually show them selling the drugs at all. They only show the killing people part of it. I'm guessing the drugs thing is going good though. I don't know.
You gonna get down or you gonna fucking lay down? Oh, what is it gonna be, players? Y'all gonna get down or lay down?
Get down.
Huh?
Get down.
I think.
Beanie Sigel got a new house and everybody having fun now and wearing Roc-A-Fella. Everybody look great in their Roc-A-Fella. Beanie Sigel girlfriend not actually having fun though. She real worried about him and she want him to spend more time at home. Bitch, this nigga's a fucking murderer. What the fuck? You should be concerned about that shit first. This nigga is a legit serial killer. He not even fazed by that shit.
What's up, kid? You need something?
What I need?
Look like I fucking smoke crack.
Get down.
What I need you to do is deliver me a fucking message. Tell your man Butter that Beans came through.
They gotta defeat the next drug dealer now and take over more territory.
You already know what it is. Either get down or you gonna lay down.
Fuck y'all niggas. I see you in the street.
Put your 3D glasses on then, pussy. Cause you know we coming straight at you.
Fucking basketball playing ass nigga, man.
That nigga gotta go.
Yeah, this nigga, man. Shut the fuck up, man.
They got this one homeboy they all be treating like shit every day. They be yelling at him when he trying to celebrate and shit. It's very similar to Belly, actually. A lot of things here are similar to Belly. This movie a fake Belly.
Nigga stay running his fucking mouth.
You talk too fucking much, man.
Roll up, man. Do your fucking job.
Roll the fuck up. Nigga, fuck you, man. I ain't doing shit, man. I'm tired of this shit.
Oh. The fuck out of here.
You just say fuck you. Look at
you. You ain't just say that, did you, E? Huh? Huh? What the fuck you say? You think it's funny, right? What the fuck you just say? Where you roll up with, matter of fact? Man, you roll up with. Put your shit right there. Didn't I tell you?
No,
Beans. Didn't I tell you to roll up, E? Didn't I tell you to roll up?
No, Beans. No, Beans.
They roll up on the next drug dealer, then they shoot him and kill him at this crowded basketball game. That's what I'm talking about with this nigga. That's fucking so OD. I hope these niggas go to jail.
Please,
bro.
So crowded basketball
Something happens with Beanie Sigel plug, and now he gotta wait a week for his drugs. He hate waiting a week for his drugs though, so he decided to go talk to the big boss directly. He taking initiative. He a good businessman. He killing people.
Don't be bullshitting when we get the fuck out there, neither.
Whatever, nigga. Who the fuck the right hand, nigga?
Fuck out of here, nigga.
Don't take my motherfucking glizzy.
Welcome, welcome, gentlemen.
Yo, what up?
What are you drinking?
A couple shots of corny ass.
Benito, I got key.
Nah, Benito, whatever he said, we don't want no fucking drinks.
For all we know, they have a fucking 1,000 Gualas running through this motherfucker. Kill us and take the fucking money.
Beanie Sigel and Baby Boy meet the plug. This little weird Spanish teenager. It goes great too. The whole deal goes great. Even though Beanie Sigel's being an asshole the whole time.
I'm gonna talk English, man, with that Guala Guala stuff, man.
Then they get back to Philly. Memphis Bleek is upset about money or something in the movie, and probably real life too. Honestly, all these Roc-A-Fella niggas, they just gone from the world. They all Roc-A-Fella off. Where are these niggas?
Bean's the one making all that real fucking money, man. We the soldiers putting in the real fucking work. We the killers niggas in the street is scared of.
Didn't you just buy a new car? Fuck you talking about Bean's getting all the money? Bought you from a have-not nigga to a have-got nigga.
Yeah, but we could, man. Fuck all that shit.
Trust me. That nigga hating on you hard, saying you the only nigga getting money. He gonna try to hook up with your connect and start his own shit.
What? Dude, keep a close eye on that motherfucker, too. Sneaky ass nigga. I got something for him.
Beanie Sigel comes up with a plan to kill the next drug dealer. They get some girl to set the nigga up or something. Pretty standard stuff. Also, Beanie Sigel has a plan for Memphis Bleek too, since he was plotting on him.
See, the more money you make, the more problems you make. If you gotta ride outside the city limits 2 miles to use the payphone, that's what you gotta do.
18
Precinct, may I help you? Yo, look, hurry up, man. I ain't got a whole lot of time, man. Hurry up.
Boy, don't be rushing me. I'm about to treat you to something real nice, all right?
Go in the house.
Yo, Bing says suck on this, nigga.
Cap your ass and your ass. You want some too?
You got him, Jink.
Okay, correct me if I'm wrong here. Did Beanie Sigel just call the cops on this nigga? Am I tripping or something? That's not gangster at all. Why would they make him do that? I must be tripping.
18 Precinct, may I help you?
Because it was a lot of fucking hard work out there in them streets. I mean, don't get me wrong. Y'all my motherfucking winning team right now. But don't get it twisted for a motherfucking second. Now, y'all see this shit right here? These motherfucking rings? These is for my top dogs right here. When y'all put that shit on, that shit mean for life.
They all get gang rings now, and that's pretty lame and stupid. But hey, they're gangsters though, so you can't tell them that or they're gonna beat you up.
No, Beanie.
Beanie Sigel getting stronger because he got his Roc-A-Fella gang member rings. He gotta defeat the next drug dealer now, and this one's super strong. He like a boss fight kinda. Also, Beanie Sigel really hate these niggas for some reason. He start narrating and roasting the fuck out of them immediately while he's narrating. It's really uncalled for.
These old ass niggas right here call themselves drug dealers. I mean, look at they squad. Weirdos, they slop. Look at these cats, joking, laughing. Like life's a joke, life's funny. Yeah, right. They don't have a clue what's about to happen.
Like, bro, they just laughing. Give them a break. This nigga too gangster to laugh occasionally? How's he even seeing this shit right now? He's not really here. Like, how do you even know what they're doing right now? I thought he's just supposed to narrate his parts and shit.
That nigga stay running his fucking mouth.
You talk too fucking much.
Anyway, Dame Dash is in the movie, as you can see. He's the high-level drug dealer, and he loves Roc-A-Fella also. Both the gangs wear Roc-A-Fella exclusively. This is actually my favorite character in the whole movie. He's kind of funny. He's like the only motherfucker with an actual personality now that I think about it. Everybody else is just random killers. They made everybody else too gangster and forgot to give them personalities. That's hilarious.
Understand me, I don't even know you, man. I mean, I don't even know y'all niggas exist. Y'all niggas call us a beef. All you doing is making yourself hot. You not affecting me, nigga. I got cake. You making me sick. Actually, I'm laughing at you.
We all laughing at you.
If it's gonna happen, it's gonna happen. All right? Just
get my Beanie Sigel then calls this one nigga named Caesar. He owned a car detail spot and he sell drugs out of it, I'm guessing. He a drug dealer. Beanie Sigel wanna take it over. You know what happens next, it's fine. Go ahead, shoot him, Beanie Sigel.
Yeah, you either gonna get down or you gonna fucking lay down.
Say it, man, calm down.
Now what you gonna do, man?
That shit up. What the fuck you doing, man?
Fuck you.
Fucking answer you, yeah.
Yo, it's Dane.
Yo, what's up, Dane?
Talk to you about something. I'm gonna come over here in a little while.
What?
All right, man. I'm gonna get back at you. Just give me a minute.
Can't save my ass, nigga.
Yeah, well, watch. Lock the door, man.
Yeah, all right, nigga.
If you find some ass or something, you wouldn't be so fucking violent.
Dame Dash and his friends deep as shit in the club in this young ass booth.
Oh my God.
I thought these niggas was getting money, bro. Are you kidding me?
It ain't no
trip, man.
Oh, bullshit fellas.
Hey, yo, I know that's not being this bitch out here like everything is peaches. Hey, yo, watch this. Hey, Ma, come here.
Oh, no, we didn't order this. This is courtesy of the gentleman over there.
Okay. Come on, let's go over there. Come on, let's go. You wanna go?
You know I can't go over there.
Well, y'all is acting real chicken. I'm out of here.
Thanks for the champagne.
Oh, it's all good. Come sit next to me. Come on. Actually sent the champagne to your homegirl, man. Why she acting like that? A little antisocial? She got a cold?
And she got a man and he be bugging.
Who's that man?
Beans. And if he come up in here, it's gonna be trouble.
Fuck me. Hold on. Tell your girl if she wants to get a real man, you know, come fuck with me.
What? Out of here.
Jay-Z tells Dame Dash that he should kidnap Beanie Sigel's girlfriend. That's not cool, Jay-Z. Why you say that? This is pretty much it for Jay-Z, by the way. He don't do shit else. He's not really in the movie at all. This nigga filmed all his scenes in one day, I'm sure.
Yo, what's up?
Wake up, nigga.
Got your bitch.
Fuck is this?
You wanna see your bitch, man? Act like you know.
What bitch?
This bitch.
Nigga.
Bree!
I figure she's worth about 500,000, about 50 of them things, pause.
You gonna get your money, all right? Cause you gonna need that shit to bury your fucking mother.
Shit! Just to let you know I'm serious.
Hey, Bob, shoot that bitch.
Beanie Sigel pays the ransom and he gets his girl back. She happy now. After that, we go back to Caesar. Remember Caesar from the car shit? He actually survived and now the police want to know what happened.
Man, look at this fucking bitch ass nigga right here. Hustler's number one rule. You never snitch. I mean, ever. Not even on your worst enemy. You never, ever snitch. But as you can see, that's a rule that's rarely followed.
You know, I like how this nigga was casually murdering hella people. Now he trying to blame somebody else for getting caught. You were not careful at all, sir. You can't just shoot everybody. You also called the cops on your own homeboy. What the fuck was that? That never gets resolved.
Yo, I'll be right back. I gotta go do something real quick. What's wrong with you?
what is it, that Tanya situation about the kidnap? Look, I told you I was gonna handle that shit.
I want your daughter to have a dad. You know you go to court, I mean, what is you thinking about?
What's wrong with you, man?
This nigga said, you still mad over the kidnapping. Yes, she probably is. You sound crazy right now. Who wrote this shit, bro? I feel like niggas wrote this shit in a jail cell. Also, listen to this weak-ass soap opera music. This should sound like Minecraft music.
Don't worry about it. You gonna be all right. Stinky black guy.
It's a bad idea, man. I don't think we should be out in the open like this already, man. It's still hot and everything. You know what I'm saying? I'm just saying, man. We gotta be smart. You know what I'm saying?
What's wrong? Now with you nervous? Nah, man.
Bro, how is his acting still so bad and he's not even saying shit right now? This nigga doing like some fucking WWE acting. Then Dame Dash comes into the club. This fucking same ass club they've been reusing since the beginning of the movie. They did like 5 scenes here. Beanie Sigel then goes to meet up with his lawyers to talk about shooting Caesar.
They say Caesar's going to testify against you for attempted murder.
I really think it's a bluff.
Man, bluff my dick.
This case is too high profile. It's been on TV and all the newspapers, shootouts in public places, bodies turning up all over the city.
Fuck, man. Look, I got a fucking family. A daughter to take care of.
Oh no, you better fucking stop it, movie. Don't try to be relatable now, motherfucker. Are you kidding me? This nigga is so unlikable. Like, why would I ever be rooting for him? He complained about his life at the beginning of the movie a little bit, and I'm supposed to care about him? The first thing we really see him do is beat an old man to death with a bat. They should have gave this nigga at least one good quality to balance him out. This nigga is a psychopath. This nigga is shooting up basketball games. That's not relatable.
Stinky black guy.
Jay-Z pops up again, and he puts a call into his assassin lady. This the assassin lady right here. She a rapper too. I never heard of most of these fucking rappers actually. I'm only pointing them out for you guys. Also, I'm sure I probably missed a bunch of them too. I'm sorry. Anyway, Jay-Z is putting a hit out on Beanie Sigel. At least I think he is. He's using this fucking hilarious made up secret language.
Yeah, look. Usual shamils like that go with his name. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, you know I got you.
You know his name, right?
Yeah.
It's time for the trial now. Beanie Sigel ends up paying Caesar like $1 million or something to keep him quiet. He looks like he's gonna do it. But just to be sure, Beanie Sigel friends come into the courthouse and kill him anyway. These niggas shooting up the courthouse now? That's fucking top tier savage shit. What the fuck? These niggas crazy.
I knew I'd be rotting a bench one day, but not like this. In front of my daughter? I mean, what the fuck was baby boy and D-Nice thinking? But that shit was gangster though, right? Keep it real, I went out like a gangster.
Bro, what a piece of shit. He's not even concerned about what his family went through. Your girl got kidnapped. Your daughter just saw hella people die in front of her. This nigga laughing, joking, like life's a joke, like life's funny.
These old ass niggas. Bullshit. That shit only happened in the fucking movies. I got quadruple life. I'm state property. They gonna remember my name. They gonna remember Beans.
Okay, wait, I'm confused. That shit didn't happen then? So what happened? He had a regular ass trial and he was just daydreaming? What about the hitman lady? Did that really happen? Did he really call her?
You know, usually she knows like that.
So I guess he not dead though. I guess he in jail. I don't feel bad for him. This is exactly what jail is made for, actually. Get this nigga the fuck out of here, man.
Stinky black bat.
This isn't the worst movie I've ever seen, but it's definitely some amateur shit, and it's got a lot of flaws. None of the characters were really interesting. None of his homeboys were interesting. The filmmakers were so focused on the gangster shit part that they forgot to do shit else. They tried to show Beanie Sigel at this birthday party and shit for like 5 seconds so they could try to say he's a family man. He's not a family man. This nigga insane, bro. He's a poorly written character. Like, it's fine if you want to have your main character a psychopath or whatever, but they were trying to play it off like he was a normal guy. Like he was just a nigga trying to get money. Maybe with some better writing and some better acting, they could have pulled that shit off. But nah, all these characters were garbage, except for Dame Dash. Everything about this shit is just very amateurish, which is fine. Not everybody's fucking Steven Spielberg or whatever, but there's really no message to this shit either. It's like, why did you even want to make this shit? To sell me Roc-A-Fella? I'm good, bro.
No, babe.
It's just glamorized, surface level hood shit. But hey, it's kind of cool. Being a rich kingpin drug dealer is cool, but killing hella people and shooting up basketball games is not cool. Don't try to turn this nigga to a fucking hero. What's wrong with you? You can pop this movie on if you want to roll up and just get lost in some gritty hood shit. You can watch it and make believe that you Beanie Sigel and you the rich kingpin. That's what I did. Make sure you guys like and subscribe. Everybody liking and subscribing to me. Everybody say I got a dumb voice. They say I sound like a nerdy Biggie Smalls. Subscribe to my other channel. Watch my other shits, hit the Cash App, and thank you, and so.
Take my motherfucking glizzy. Over.